10 Newton, and welcome to our arts class. I hope that you are all excited for today because today we will be discussing another topic and I hope that you will learn a lot. But before that, I want to introduce to you myself. I am your teacher, Kate Ann Ballesteros. And of course, let us not forget to commit our discussion for today to our Almighty God. Let us all pray.
Loving Father, you're so good to us. I thank you for this day, for giving us opportunity to learn. May you guide us in the middle of our discussion. Bless us, Father, with understanding and wisdom to easily understand our topic for today. May you rebuke whatever hindrance that we may encounter as we start our class today. In Jesus' name, Amen.
I'm back! I hope that you are now ready to listen. I want you to condition your mind as well as to your heart, listen attentively, and understand deeply our topic for today. Let us start with an activity. And with our activity for today, I want you to prepare a pencil or a ballpen, a clean sheet of paper, or a clean sheet of bond paper. You have 2 minutes to prepare for a pencil or ballpen and a bond paper or a one whole sheet of paper. I hope that you have now your materials. What you are going to do is to draw a big flower. I'll repeat, draw a big flower. And what you are going to do is to write the word abstractionism at the center of the flower. I'll repeat, draw a big flower and at the center of the flower, write the word abstractionism. I hope that you got it, class. And for our last instruction, I want you to write your idea, knowledge, and schemata on the petals of that flower. I'll repeat, what you are going with the petals is to write your knowledge, idea, and schemata about what is abstractionism. I hope that my instructions are clear, class. You have 5 minutes to do our activity. Your time starts now.
Clean up the room. Clean. pick up everything you see so we can see the floor. Clean up the room, come on, clean up the room. Everybody's helping now to clean up the room. Clean up the room, come on, clean up the room. Everybody's helping now to clean up the room. Sing while you work, yes, sing while you work. Everything feels better when you sing while you work. Dance while you sing, just dance while you sing. Everything feels better when you dance while you sing. Clean up the room, come on, clean up the room. Everybody's helping now to clean.
Time is up, and thank you for all your participation. Let us dwell more with our topic for today by answering my questions. My first question is, how did you find our activity? Yes, thank you for your idea. Indeed, it is very challenging, most especially if the word abstractionism is not familiar to you. But with our topic for today, I know that you will learn a lot. Our second question is, how did our activity help you for our today's discussion? Thank you for your idea. Yes, indeed, that our activity helped you to have an idea that our topic for today is abstractionism. Thank you for your brilliant ideas. And let us now proceed to our discussion. For today's lesson, we will be discussing the third modern art, which is the abstractionism. What do we mean by abstractionism?
Abstractionism is an art that does not attempt to represent an accurate depiction of a visual reality, but instead use shapes, colors, forms, and gestural marks to achieve its effect.
In abstractionism, the main subject is not accurately depicted, but through geometric shapes, colors, forms, and lines, the subject is still recognizable but not in just one look. Here are some characteristics of abstractionism, and they are the reasons why abstract art is not easy to interpret. And they are?
Here are the characteristics of abstractionism. First is concepts, which includes space-time and relativity. Second is, it is logical and rational. And lastly, it involves analyzing, detaching, selecting, and simplifying.
What does it mean? It simply means that for us to interpret and recognize well the subject, we need a deep analysis since the subject in abstractionisms are logical. And that is the meaning of abstractionism. Now, let us proceed to the various style of abstractionism. And the first style of abstractionism is... Oops! You have to arrange the jumbled words to get the correct answer. And the answer is... Yes, you are correct. It is cubism. The first style of abstractionism is cubism. What do we mean by cubism?
Cubism is derived from the word cube,
a three-dimensional geometric figure of strictly measured lines, planes, and angles. The cubists analyze their subject's basic geometrical form and these planes tilting and interlocking them in different ways.
In cubism, the figures that are presented are human figures, like facial, body part figures, showing the frontal part and one side angle. Now, I will show you a four pictures and tell me what pictures fall under cubism. We have also here the proponent of cubism, and he is... Oops! We have to arrange again the jumbled letters to get the correct answer. And the correct answer is... Very good! You got the correct answer. It's Pablo Picasso. Who is Pablo Picasso? I hope that you are ready to know who is Pablo Picasso. Pablo Picasso is very famous. He is a Spanish painter, a sculptor, and the famous cubist. Now, I will show you some of his artworks. What did you observe on the artwork? Yes, that is correct. And indeed, it has the characteristic of an abstract art, wherein it requires us to analyze it deeply and interpret it well to get the correct meaning. And that is cubism. Now, let us proceed to our next various style of abstractionism, which is... Oops! It requires you to arrange again the jumbled letters. And the correct answer is... Yes, you are correct. The next style of abstractionism is futurism. Again, it is futurism. What is futurism?
Futurism began in Italy in early 1900s, and futurists created art for a fast-paced machine-propelled age, and they admired the motion, force, speed, and strength of mechanical forms.
To better understand what is futurism, let us dig deeper. Who is the proponent of futurism? And he is... And yes, you have to arrange again the jumbled letters to get the correct answer. And the correct answer is... Yes, you are correct. It is Gino Severini. Who is Gino Severini? Let us together know who is Gino Severini.
Gino Severini. He is an Italian painter and a leading member of the Futurist movement. During his career, he worked in a variety of media, including mosaic and fresco. He showed his artwork in major exhibitions, including Rome Quadrennial, and won art prizes from major institutions.
I hope that you already know who is Gino Severini. Now, I will show you some of his artworks. Observe it well. That is what futurism all about. Now, let us proceed to the next style of abstractionism, which is... Wait, you have to erase again the jumbled letters. And the correct answer is... Yes, it is mechanical style. What is mechanical style?
Mechanical style. In this style, basic forms such as planes, cones, sphere, and cylinders all fit together precisely and neatly in their appointed places. Mechanical parts such as crankshafts, cylinder blocks, and positions are brightened only by the use of primary colors.
And in addition to that, Even human figures are mere outlines, rendered purposely without expression. And that is mechanical style. And now, let us proceed to the proponent of mechanical style. And he is? Yes, you have to arrange the jumbled letters to get the correct answer. And the correct answer is? And yes, you are correct. He is Ferdinand Ledger. Now, I will present to you some of the artworks of Ferdinand Ledger. Observe it well. What did you observe on the artwork of Ferdinand Ledger, class? And yes, that is a great idea. And thank you for sharing your ideas in the class. And now, let us proceed with the last style of abstractionism, which is... Oops! You have to arrange again the jumble the letters to get the correct answer. And the correct answer is... Yes, you are right. It is non-objectivism. What is non-objectivism? And together, let us know what is non-objectivism.
Non-objectivism is a logical geometrical conclusion of abstractionism. From the term non-object, works in the style did not make use of figures or even representations of figures. Lines, shapes, and colors were used in a cool, impersonal approach that aimed for balance, unity, and stability. Colors were mainly black, white, and primaries.
That is what non-objectivism all about. Now, let us also know who is the proponent of non-objectivism. And he is... Oops, you have to guess again and arrange again the jumbled letters to get the correct answer. And the correct answer is? Yes, you are right. It is Piet Mondrian. Now, let us know who is Piet Mondrian.
Piet Mondrian was born on March 7, 1872 in Netherlands. He was a theorist, writer, and artist reflected the underlying spirituality of nature. Used basic colors and forms like simple and basic logical manner.
Indeed, he is a talented man. Now, to amaze you more, I will present you some of his artwork. Take a look and observe. What did you observe, class? Isn't it amazing? Yes, indeed. He is amazing. And thank you for sharing your ideas. And that ends our discussion for today.
To test if you really understand our topic, we now proceed with your enrichment activity. I will show you a picture or an artwork, then tell me what style does it fall and the proponent. And the first picture is, guess the correct answer. And the correct answer is futurism. And the proponent is Gino Severini. And you got it right. And our next picture is, what is the correct answer? Yes, you are right. It is a mechanical style and the proponent is Ferdinand Ledger. And the third picture is, what do you think is the answer? Yes, it is cubism and the proponent is Pablo Picasso. And last but not the least, what do you think is the answer? Yes, you are right. It is non-objectivism, and the proponent is Piet Mondrian.
And that ends our discussion for today. Now, let us summarize what we discussed for today. And for your information, today we discuss about abstractionism. And in abstractionism, we have four styles, which are the cubism, futurism, mechanical style, and non-objectivism. And in four various style, we have the proponents. In cubism, we have here Pablo Picasso. In futurism, we have Gino Severini. And in mechanical style, we have also Ferdinand Leger. And lastly, in non-objectivism, we have Piet Mondrian. And that ends our topic for today, and I hope that you learned something. And of course, it will not end on that, because we will also have our last activity. Are you ready? I hope that you are ready. I will now present to you the instruction or the mechanics of our last activity. Here is the rubric for your activity. You may now start doing your activity, and you have 10 minutes to finish your activity. And your time starts now. Time is up! I hope that you enjoyed our activity. And pass your activity on our GC, and I will grade it individually. Job well done, class! And for your follow-up assignment, I want you to create an acrostic on the word abstractionism and base from its meaning and characteristic. And for your advanced assignment, I want you to have an advanced reading about pop art. God bless everyone and read well. That ends our class, and keep safe always, and God bless everyone.